playthrough of Stardew Valley. I then realized after the first vid that the average day took about 20 minutes. So yeah, that wasn't going to happen. So what I'm going to be doing is, I'm going to be laying out tips and tricks to helping you get good money and a good base to getting to doing good with at least your first year on the farm. Once you have the first year done, you have the basics done, you have everything done. Because Stardew Valley, once you understand the basics and the mechanics of the game, is very straightforward and very enjoyable. Back for a name. Alright. Let's just be quick. You know what? Skip it. Bam. Done. We're doing this. Alright. Skipping the intro. And we begin the first day. Now, the first thing you want to do during your first 48 hours is you want to get your parsnips ready, you want to get your farm ready, and you want to check for the next day's weather. Now, checking for the weather is very important because you'll know if you're going to have to water your crops the next day or not. Also, I believe working out in the rain is bad for your stamina. Times two, cost, and all that. Haven't checked it, but same time, it's what I believe. Let's see here. You also want to check the fortune teller because you'll be able to tell by the neutral or lower or anything higher what the range is going to modifier is going to be for you. If they're annoyed, if your luck's not going to be as great, then that means you're not going to be as likely to get good random stuff like quality crops or ores when you're mining regular rocks. So you actually want to make sure that you check it to know if it's going to be a good day to harvest your crops or not. But usually you harvest your crops anyway because, well, you gotta harvest your crops. Right, and this is actually a good time to mess with your makeup. Making sure that your crop, making sure that your tools are all in the right area that are good just for you. Now you also want to make sure, now you can set up your farm any way you want. You don't have to listen, little tip here, and make your crops in any way particular form. I normally keep them outside of the house, and I keep them in a nice straight line unless they're impassable. Which there are only a few crops that are truly impassable. I'm not going to mention them because I forgot. But hey, I don't use them, so that's why I forgot. Now, let's see here. In the beginning, you cannot craft fertilizer. That comes later in the game, and you're usually taught how to do it through a mail message. So, that means I'm going to have to settle for just using all the seeds I have right now without any fertilizer, and then just watering them. Once you have that down, you just water your crops and get going. Now, this is a good opportunity, because after this, I'm just going to start cutting down trees and getting things done. Foraging a little bit later, but really focusing on the trees right now, because I'm going to need 300 wood to get into that across the bridge area on the beach. Because in the beginning of the game, the bridge is down and not usable. And you want to get across the bridge because there are, on most days, sea forageables like coral or clams or some fishing items do pop up on the area next to it, across that bridge, which you'll be able to sell for high amounts of money, and any quick sources of money is good for your early game. Now I'm spending most of my stamina here in the beginning, because that way I know where my limits are, and anything I grab extra from food or otherwise is ready for me to is ready for me the next day. So most of your beginning of the days in the spring will work out like this. Farming is very important in mid and late game, so you want to make sure you spend some time in the spring setting up basic farm goods. So after I'm done topping down these trees, and whew, cutting really close there, I'm gonna go get potatoes. Now normally, if you're going by profit to time ratio, you wanna go cauliflower. costs the most, sure, but you also get the most out of it. After that, though, is potatoes, and it goes on from there. Parsnips are like fourth or fifth in the line. But after that, everything works fine. Now, right now, I have 90 wood. On the first day, that's not too bad, but you want to get more, because you need 300 wood to cross the bridge. And this is a 48-hour run, so I'm trying to make sure I can do it, do everything I need within that 48 hours, not within 3 days. So once I get the potato seeds, well, maybe 8 of them, I'm going to start foraging for consumables, which I'll be able to then eat and continue working. Now, during the spring, it's also important if you have a challenge to yourself, like marrying within the first year, which is possible. But in my test game, I was able to marry within the first year by finding which flowers my wafu locked, which was Penny, by the way. And going on with that. Now, until you get the backpack upgrade, you're also going to have to be careful with how your items are chosen, how you use your space. Now, since you don't get fertilizer until later, I'm just going to throw out this sap. Because those mixed seeds can be useful if you spend the time using them. So right now, I'm going to go up and above looking for a dandelion, because my waffle is Penny. And Penny is Penny. Which I don't need to give gifts, because at the same time, you could also do that. You'll have the opportunity until Sunday to give 2 gifts to any person before the... It's Saturday or Sunday. That before the cycle resets and you're able to give them more goods. Now in the spring, unless she goes to the library, Penny normally sits over here and reads to the children or reads a silver book by herself. Now, since I got that done, it's time for me to sell my goods and make a chest. Now, why am I making a chest if my goal is to collect 300 wood by the end of the day? You're very astute to notice that. The thing is, you need storage space to collect all the goods that you can or will sell. Normally, I don't sell my items like clay, which is a good resource for silos or buildings, and I don't sell other stuff like that. But I'm going to need to if I'm going to be able to collect everything I need and still be useful. Have it right outside the door, and it's ready to go when I need it. And it can't be destroyed by storms or anything like that. Now, since I need to go... Oh, that's right. And until you get anything like the wood sword that can chop for free, you might want to keep your scythe nearby, but it's also not truly necessary, which opens up a free space for you to carry around the stuff you need in foraging, especially if you already used your hoe. Let's see here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 8. Yep. Because I thought ahead to create up the spaces, I could also put the hoe away because I'm not going to use those big seeds just yet. I'm probably going to do it tomorrow when I have the stamina, leftover stamina to do so. Or right now, because I miscounted. Either way, now I'm going to go into the forest to collect consumables to restore my health if needed. Now I'm going to test if there's a clear path to the... There doesn't seem to be a clear path to the base of each of the other go into town and around. Sometimes you can get a clear path to the bottom of your farm, which makes things easier because then you can just go to the forest from there. Now I like to go into the forest on the first day because you can still collect goods on that first day. Don't forget to look at your quests. You sometimes can get daily quests which are on part in front. Of the storefront, right here, in the prairies. Here's the calendar for when you need to check birthdays. Giving a gift on a person's birthday, if they like it, will skyrocket their friendship points to you almost to a full heart. Almost guaranteed, and a good way to get close to somebody. Next to it, however, is a job posting that was born, which you can accept daily quests on normally, which can give you money in exchange for giving an item, finding an item, or etc. Normally, you have to deliver the item to the person, so which can means unless it's a good profit margin, you normally don't want to do it. Because wisely spending your time is the most important thing to do in the first and early seasons. And usually, the quest since you already have the item is not usually worth it to begin with, especially since you have to go back to your farm, which is easily 30 minutes or to an hour spent just collecting the item to give them. Now, in the forest, you can normally find consumables like horseradish or leeks, but unfortunately, since today's a bad luck day, I'm not very likely to get silvers or golds when I'm foraging, especially since my skill is low. That's why you want to know is if it's a good time or not to forage. Now, since we've already moved on to consumables, and I've already displayed the necessary, the usefulness of getting 300 wood for the area across the beach, I'm going to move into tiers of stamina usage. Now, first and foremost, the most money-making possible thing to do in the game so far is just farming. Because once you get to level 10, there's an ability to make your artisan goods, like wine or cheese or otherwise, worth 50% more. No matter how you count that, that is a huge increase in profit, 50%. The thing is, however, the reason why it's 50% is probably because the infrastructure to make those items is annoyingly hard to build up. Now, see, just by traveling into the forest, I was able to get enough items to get the equivalent of 150-ish of stamina. That means I have enough stamina to go about and finish the last of my day's chores, which is to collect more wood and water the rest of those crops. Now the problem is, yes, farming is going to be difficult, especially since I'm going to have all those crops to water without any proficiency in the watering can. Now it's going to hurt my stamina and market greatly, but that's why you go foraging the first day to make sure that you have enough consumable goods to continue up with your needs. However, there are always going to be misclicks and otherwise, unless you spend your time religiously. But you don't have the time to spend your... You don't have time to always make sure that every single watering is perfect, especially since, well, time can get away from you in this game very quickly. Another tip that otherwise is just the people is, in the beginning of the game, go into your general options and always show the tool hit location. This will bring in a little red square that will show you where the place you'll affect is going to show up. Very important to have, because otherwise it will help lower the amount of misclicks you'll have. Now, so far, besides the 50 wood reduction I had in the beginning to craft that chest, I now have up to 56 wood. It's good to have wood. It's lovely to have wood, and I have a lot of wood. Ladies love wood. Now, the closer you get to 300, the closer you get to the early day objectives, the 48-hour objectives. And you want to get as close as possible to 300 wood within 48 hours, because then that means you're able to go into that beach and collect those expensive items that you can sell very easy cash. Now, since we covered tiers, we covered the first 48 hours, I'm going to go into the stamina usage as an order of importance. You already said it's going to be farming. Well, after that, it's going to be mining. Mining is very important, and it's what you do on days when it's raining. Because when it's raining, then you have all the time to yourself to go mining. If you're lucky, and the lower you go, you can get diamonds that are worth 1,000 gold each. And no matter how you cut that, that's 1,000 gold. 1,000 gold for your use. Now, right now, I have 125 wood. That's great. I'm going to be selling the sap, the acorn, and all that jazz. Normally with foraging in the later hours, you don't want to sell your goods like the acorn. But that's how it is. I'm gonna go up into the, I'm gonna go up this time and see if there's any forageables for the north side of the house. I was very surprised not to see any dandelions within the forest, but there was a lot of spring onions, which made it up. Now, during the summer, the way to the bathhouse will be cleared. That's very useful too during the summer, because then you can water down all your crops, which you'll be spending a lot of time on in the beginning, and then you can rest yourself up to go into the mines later. Now, in the beginning, you can't use the mine within the first several days. That's because of a story incident, which you'll be explained to later. So right now, we're stuck into this area, which I've already explored and shown very little resourceful goods in. I'm down to 3 spring onions, and, well, I'm probably going to have to go to bed early to show what I have for my time. Now, lucky for me, I have under 126 wood, and that's after spending 50 for that chest, which means that I'm very close to my goal and should be able to accomplish it by tomorrow. And then by that time, I can show you the usefulness of that area. Now, after mining, foraging is useful, but only during certain times of the month. In late spring, and late summer, and late fall, berries appear on the bushes around town and around everywhere around the city. You'll be able to collect those berries at about maybe 100 per time, and they'll restore 20 stamina each, which is a lot of stamina, about 2,000 just by raw math, 100 times 20. Bam. Now, as I said earlier, you don't want to give away you don't want to sell the seeds that you get from the trees, because as you just see from that field ration, I would be able to make it into a eatable snack for a decent amount of energy. However, I only got that acorn, and that was probably because of the bad luck. I only got that one single acorn. Again, it's going to be another bad luck day, so it's unlikely that anything is going to be good. But it's going to rain tomorrow, which means I will not have to water all these crops, and can focus probably on the mines that they open up the day after. If not, then I can just finish up on cutting more wood and probably selling that if needed. Because after you get the bridge up, you want to get the backpack upgrade so you can carry stuff deeper into the mines and everything the mines will give you. A lot of the gems and geodes you collect there are important to sell, especially for good money and for good mining, because proficiency means that everything you do is going to be easier. Now, as you can see, these mails, normally sent to your mailbox, tell you important details about what is going to be available to you from quests, from character info, and sometimes you might even get gifts from the friends you make in this game. Now, I genuinely find it important to clear the area around your farm to at least a reasonable degree, because then you could focus on the area around it afterwards, because that means you can put more farming down and everything. Now, the reason why mining is the second most important compared to farming is because how it can easily adapt to farming. There is an item after you get a couple levels of farming and mining called the sprinkler. For 1 copper bar and 1 iron bar, the sprinkler can water 4 areas around it every day. Usually not useful on the first day of the season, but after that it's incredibly useful. Because once you set up a network of sprinklers, you never have to water your crops again unless they're impassable, like stilts or grapes or hops. Which is also one of the most important items you should farm for once the summer comes around. Because when turned into wine, hops are incredibly powerful in price. Because they can turn into pale ales, which are easy to sell and very profitable. I see we have 3 acorns and 3 maple seeds. I should be focusing on pine trees right now, which is rather odd that we got so many, but hey, luck is luck. And they probably got them because of the foraging skill being up, because after the first level of foraging, you more likely collect acorns from the trees you chop down. And that's two field stacks. And we're already up to 211 wood. Everything's going great so far. Well, except we're getting no flowers, but hey. That's what range does to you sometimes. Sometimes you don't get anything from the trees, besides, you know, the initial wood that you wanted. Eh, tough luck. Now, buildings. You always want to get a silo first, because you'll be noticed, I don't cut down any of this grass, despite it slowing me down. And that's because when you have a silo, any grass you cut with a scythe turns into hay. And that's why you want to keep your scythe during the later part, even though you may be thinking, well, what's the point of the scythe? The point of the scythe is to collect grass, is to collect hay to feed your animals. I see a lot of comments about people not knowing about that, and then not being able to feed their animals later. Ooh, a leak. Gotta love them leaks. And a dandelion! Excellent! Now, not many people know this, but there's actually an area to the left that you can go in and check for stuff. Nope, nothing there. And another dandelion. I'll just probably throw that to somebody. Now, we got a silver dandelion. That means it has better stats, and as you can see, can restore a lot more energy. But because my partner locks the dandelion, I'm gonna give it to her. Right. Now, in the video description, I will also show a vid of my main farm's layout in my other actual saved game, or main game. And you'll be able to see the way I have my sprinklers set up and how useful they are. It's during winter at the moment in that game, but at the same time they're very useful and I don't have to water them. Now as you can see, Penelot Dunflower. And that's the usefulness behind gifts. Because when it gets Saturday or Sunday, you can only give two gifts per week, but when that Saturday or Sunday hits, it rolls over, and I can give gifts again. So that's why it's important to keep your items on you, or keep them in a chest, because you just can't dump them as soon as you get them. Apparently old guys like flowers. You always seem a little bit weird to me. Now the reason why you want to dump your daffodils, your dandelions, your daffodils, is because you cannot eat them and gain anything from them. So you want to get rid of them, or at least store them. And you also want to get friends, because friends can give you nice bonuses, like free goods, or sometimes free information you didn't have. And it always leads to better things. Oh, by the way, one of the main reasons you also want to keep that area open in the beach that we're fighting for, that we're rushing towards, by the way, is because during rainy days, an NPC called an old weird guy, an old mariner, shows up on that secluded area of the beach during rainy days. And you want to go across it, and you want to be on those rainy days, because he sells, if you have a single person to affection up to 10 hearts, a item that allows you to marry the person with a person with 10 hearts that is single. All right, one more tree and it'll be ready, and then I'll be able to show you the beauty of that area. We should find a maple we need to find an oak, because we have a maple seed and a pine cone seed, but not an acorn seed. There we go. And also want to check this area, because sometimes daily the spring onions can show up, and as you can see, they're very useful when you get the equivalent of 100 stamina from them, as well as the field rations from them as well. Now, I have 300 wood. That means my objective is complete, and I can show you the wonderful usage of that area in the southeast of the beach, the east of the beach. Now, since we covered tiers of stamina usage and we covered the tiers of effective skills, we're going to move into the basic day-by-day strategy. Now, once the mine is up and you've watered your daily crops, you should head to the mine after you water your crops and then start going deeper and deeper into the mines. That is after you're sure that you have enough copper and iron to set up your sprinklers, which is going to be in the first 20 or 30, and then the 30 to 50 range. Normally, I'm going to skip this cinematic because, well, that's for the people who are going to be in the game to enjoy. Don't want to ruin nothing for you, even if it's going to be for the first couple days. You're just going to get the gameplay. Gameplay's nice. Now the area is crafted, and I'm going to be able to move across it. I got the bamboo pole from the dude, so that means I'm going to have a slot taken. But at the same time, now I got sea urchins, and I got coral. They sell pretty nicely, but today it seems like only 3 items showed up. Could be worse. Now, this area does not fill up all the time with goods, but then again, so doesn't the beach, so you have to check it almost every other day. I normally check it every other day, so that way things have a time to build up and I have more profit to sell immediately. At the end of the day, I'll show you how much this coral is worth and how much sea urchin is worth and how it's a good idea to go into that side of the beach. Now, besides the mentioned sprinklers, mine usage, stamina usage. Right. Oh, right, and the ammo barn usage. As you mentioned, hay is very important because if you don't have hay, your animals will not be happy, and they will not create food to sell. No eggs, no milk, etc., etc. So from the beginning of the game, you want to make sure you have the silo first, filled up to 240 hay, that's the max you can hold, and then buy the coop or the barn. And then you want to make sure that for every building you have a silo that can go with it. Because during the winter, you can't get hay. All the grass, gone. So since hay also costs 50 gold each from the store, you don't want to spend that money to get it, to buy it. Hello, Mr. Hobo. So let's see here. No forageables left. Day's pretty much done. I've completed my objective. I'm going to keep the goods for myself so I can continue. And since I'm waiting now on the mine to be finished because foraging is a third tier usage, I'm probably going to go back to the farm, clear out a little bit of clear a bit more of it, and then since I'm going to be clearing out the weeds and trees next to the crops, I don't have to build a fence. I should, however, build a scarecrow when I have the option, but that's going to be when the mine's up, so I'm good for now. I'm going to try to cut down more trees to see if I can do this quest. Now, right now, I can't get an earth crystal because that's in the mine, and most quests are open for 2 days. It's very unlikely I'm going to be able to get an earth crystal within those 2 days. And while 150 gold is nice because it gets me closer to the backpack, it's something I'm going to have to not accept. Now, since I've spent most of the day and everything's ready, I'm going to spend the time to try and talk to everybody. Because then that means I can get that 150 gold that comes from the secondary quest of introductions. Once you meet all 120 people, you get about 100 or 150 gold. Now usually, that's something you're going to complete over a long period of time. And something you probably can't do. Now you may think, why don't you just take that garbage? Well, sometimes you can collect food from other people's garbage. You want to make sure nobody sees you because that kind of lowers friendship points and nobody likes garbage rooter. But, hey, free food's free food. Alright. I'm probably going to eat a spring leek and cut down a tree, but that's going to be the end of the 48 hours and the challenge. Because then I'm going to be able to show you how useful that coral is and how I'm going to be set up once the mine's open. Now, in the description of the video, I'm going to put down a link to a Dropbox in which you'll be able to see the money values for most of the items you could sell. Now, I collected this off of Reddit. I don't normally go to Reddit, but hey, any place you can get stuff, free stuff off of or use or important useful info is good. As it's going to rain tomorrow, that means if the mine's going to be open, I'm going to be using it. And thank you for your time, everybody. But that's the end of the video. And I hope you all have a nice life. In the farm. Thank you. And goodbye. And that's why you want to click the beach open, because it's going to bring you a lot of money very quickly. More money than you would be if you were selling all that wood to begin with. And you should be able to see. Which probably this video is going to drag on just for a little bit longer, if the mines are open or not. Nope. So yeah.